hold it, man, hold it. What? Wait. What the fuck is this kid doing in here? Get the hell out of here before I kick your little ass.
So the undisputed pitcher in the 140 pounds is pretty much set for the tournament to begin, right? But some of these guys still have current fights that they have to get through before the tournament can begin, right? You have Isaac Pitbull Cruz, who just left the ring. Technically, as long as he don't sign a contract to fight, he's good to go for unification, right? He just left the ring versus Rolly Romero. He wins the WBA Super Light Championship belt. And, bruh, could be a shoo-in to be undisputed, as the other guys possibly can't beat him, right? You get Teofimo Lopez, who is the WBO champion at 140. He's seen Jermaine Ortiz, which was a questionable win for him. But he wins nonetheless. I think he still is busy right now because he have a fight coming up. So he would have to be on the back end trying to get into the Undisputed Showdown. You have Devin Haney, who just left the ring with Ryan Garcia, who defeated Devin Haney. But it's so much going on now, man. You get the PED scenario playing out. You also get it's sounding like Devin Haney taking this to the Justice Department in the actual world, not the sport of boxing, but the actual world, to, I guess, open up a lawsuit on the likes of Ryan Garcia. And so much going on there. Although he is still WBC champion, we probably won't see Devin Haney until after we see Teofimo Lopez, right? And then you have Subrio Matias, who is the IBF champion in the 140 division, who right now has one more fight left, which is Lamparo. And he could pretty much try to unify with the likes of Isaac Pitbull Cruz if those guys can get it into writing. Saying that to say, it looks like Subrio Matias is being hunted by that of Regis Prograis. All right, now Prograis is stating that he doesn't mind, right, doing it the proper way, having one or two more fights to get back into his winning ways. But he definitely would like to see Subrio Matias. And he has some more things to say about Subrio Matias' resume. We'll show you guys that. As of right now, man, it says, I want that fight. That's the fight I want. Either late 2024 or 2025. That's the fighter I want to fight, said Regis Prograis. I know he's been talking a lot. That's an easy fight to make. We're both with Matchroom. I feel like I'll get one or two fights and then go for Matias. Now for me, bruh, this is the way to do it. If you guys can think about certain guys like Errol Spence jumping into the ring for Sebastian Fundora, right? Knowing that the last time we seen him, bruh, he was not only defeated, but he was stopped by Terrence Crawford. Like, you dig what I'm saying? That's not fair to get a championship title fight when you have guys who've been waiting in line for a long time to get a title shot. This guy just got knocked out and knocked out of the championship picture altogether. That was the Undisputed Showdown that he stepped into the ring with Terrence Crawford with. He was demolished in most people's eyes, and now he deserved to get a championship title fight in the division up, the next division up. Get out of here. And you think about Caleb Plant, same thing. The last time we seen Caleb Plant, he was fighting David Benavidez. He lost to David Benavidez convincingly. It was a loss. And he slaps Jermall Charlo, and people think he deserves a championship title fight at 160. Then, right, Jermall, I guess, apologized. And now he's going through legal things in his personal life. But he apologized to Caleb Plant the whole nine. And Jermall is feeling green, though. He want to move on with his life. And now you get Caleb Plant approaching Edgar Berlanga, right, for a championship title fight. Well, at least to be seen as number one contender to see Saul Canelo Alvarez next. Although the IBF has released a statement that Canelo Alvarez is ordered to fight William Skull, which technically might be a good fight. I don't know. I know it's going to be a lot of power coming from William, to Canelo, but we'll have to wait and see if Canelo takes the fight altogether. Saying that to say, Regis Progress is going about it the right way, wanting to get one or two more fights and then get into the ring with Silvio Matias is the proper way to do it. Get back into winning ways, become a contender, and then get your championship title fight. He says, I'll have to see when I get there with him. He's never fought anyone like me. Now, and this is where he goes on to talk about Matias's resume. He says, all the people he's been beating are C-level opponents. Progress continued about Matias. You can't say he's fought an A or B level opponent yet. And I agree with Regis Progress, but I don't know, bro. Like, maybe what he does with C-level opponents, he could do to a B or A-level opponent. Just depends on who that guy is, right? But, yeah, it is what it is. I do agree that some of the guys we don't know, so we really can't say what they are on the totem pole, the guys that he are destroying or the guys that he are having these no-mods fights with, right? It does make sense. No offense to Matias, but it does make sense. Saying that to say, he says he's definitely dangerous. He's doing his thing, but these guys he's fighting, they're trying to make him out to be a boogeyman, all right? Which lets me know, bro, that Regis Progress is hunting down the boogeyman, maybe trying to take the boogeyman moniker for himself, right? But if it's not Subrio Matias, then who at 140, right? I got two people names that pop into my head. If it's not Subrio Matias as the boogeyman at 140, then who? If you asked me, it would either be Isaac Pitbull Cruz, right? Isaac Pitbull Cruz, or it would be Gary Antoine Russell. That's just my opinion. It's crazy Isaac popped on the screen. I do think it's either Isaac Pitbull Cruz or it's Gary Antoine Russell. Isaac Pitbull Cruz has right now not only defeated Rolly Romero in knockout fashion, but has cleared his mind about not fighting the likes of Tank Davis anymore, right? He was very desperate to get that Tank fight. Maybe it was some good money there. He was very desperate to get that fight back. And you could see him taking things easy, right? He taking the easy route in his career. Somebody must have gotten his ear and told him that's not the way to go, because he changed his vision onto becoming his own guy, his own man in the sport, and becoming a champion. And yeah, he see Rolly Romero knocks him out, bro, and now his head is clean to go and fight anybody that he want to fight in the division. I think that's going to be a dangerous Isaac Pitbull Cruz. If he were to see a Teofimo Lopez or a Devin Haney or even a Subrio Matias, he could cause them problems, right? But also think about Gary Antoine Russell right now. Although he doesn't really yell and scream from the rafters for a championship title fight, bro, I do think he is just that good, bro. He hasn't had a gentleman to step into the ring with him and make it to the final bell. He's knocked out everybody in his path. I do think he has a genuine understanding of the sport of boxing, and I do think that he could cause any champion, any of the champions, any of the four right now that are holding championship title fight belts, I think he could hold those guys into a scenario where he'll give them trouble, including Isaac Pitbull Cruz. So, yeah, if it's not Subrio Matias or Isaac Pitbull Cruz, it's definitely Gary Antoine Russell. Progress goes on to say, I don't buy it. You got to ask what high-level fighter did he fight? None, right? He stopped everybody. He's supposed to fight these guys. They're not high-level guys, but it's going to be different when he gets in there with a high-level guy. I beg to differ. Maybe, right? Maybe it'll be different if he steps in there with a high-level guy, but also maybe it won't be, right? Because sometimes you can say a guy's high-level because he got a name, right? Because he have a reputation, and the sport of boxing has pushed him into the right spots, right? To get him those big fights, right? And then he fighting guys that's not really that good at his level. Let's keep it all the way up. Being, I mean, Sandor Martin wasn't supposed to give Teofimo Lopez a run for his money, but he did. And people say Teofimo Lopez is a high-level guy. Jermaine Ortiz wasn't supposed to have as much success with the likes of Teofimo Lopez. Again, same thing. You think about Naoya Inoue, Stephen Fulton. Most people said that Inoue wouldn't have had a chance with the likes of Stephen Fulton. The only people I heard that said Inoue had a chance with the likes of Stephen Fulton were the Japanese. that was it, bro. And some few Americans that also said he had a chance with Stephen Fulton. I didn't even think that he had a chance with Stephen Fulton. They kept saying he wasn't fighting nobody, right? And then he stepped into the ring with Stephen Fulton and dominated him. Not only did he dominate him, but he knocked him out, right? So, yeah, you can say he's fighting C-level guys. Oh, not to mention Terrence Crawford, Errol Spence. Everybody brought that up, right? Terrence Crawford only fought C-level opponents. He ain't really fighting nobody. The guys he fought from PBC, Errol Spence is already beat. Like, all of that, right? They brought all that up, and he dominated Spence on the night. And it got so bad, they was coming up with excuses for Spence for at least a year. Right, for at least a year. You hear Ryan Garcia still saying Spence was high on the night of the fight. Like, come on, why would he get high the night of the fight? Like, that doesn't make no sense, right? But saying that to say, yeah, just because you're saying he's a C-level fighter, just because you're saying that somebody is supposed to be an A-level fighter, doesn't necessarily mean that they are, right? It really comes down to a game plan, one night, and one fight. But it is what it is in the aspect. I'm still with seeing this fight because, you know, Progress is trying to do it the proper way. Go through the one or two more fights, become a contender for Matias, and then see him, which is legit if you ask me. Not to mention talking about his resume. So that's going to show on the night if you have a real good game plan to step into the ring with the likes of Silvio Matias and, do some damage there. I've been watching Progress as of lately, bro. His feet work is getting better, bro. He's been really practicing on it. He's been really training on it, bro. So that could be a problem for the likes of Matias. Although I've seen Matias take people best tools away from them on fight night, bro, and have them handicapped going into the mid to late rounds where he usually knocks them out, or they usually are too shy to come out of their corner for the next round. So it is what it is. This is Fist Factory. I'm your host, Neff, and I'm signing out. I actually got what you think about the video, man. Silvio Matias, Regis Progress. Who you guys got winning it on the night if it were to happen, bruh? Leave those comments in the comment section. I'll get to you guys when I can. Again, Fist Factory, your host, Neff. I'm signing out. Y'all take it easy, bruh. Peace. Raw Night Champions for members only. Party chat debate for a shot at the community board champion. But remember, it's a fight, so don't get knocked out and lose your place in the ranks. Or if you're just here to be a part of the spectacle, that's cool too. Sign up for the first tier to get front row seats to each event and get exclusive content not seen on YouTube. No mods here, but don't get kicked out. See rule books for more details. Oh yeah, ladies and the legends are included if you want to spectate or go for some gold. Raw Night Champions, sign up now.